mean, right now,
Carol Hong, it's... for that, and we have a headline here saying that, that India's early official vote count shows a wide lead for Modi allies. We'll bring you the details as they come along. Our next guest, though, is a prominent figure in India's financial sector and one of the most influential female voices on finance. Let's get to our guest. Radhika Gupta is CEO and MD of Edelweiss Mutual Fund, which has around $16 billion in assets under management. Radhika, talk to us about that rally which we saw yesterday. Seems to be giving up a little bit of that, those gains today. Is it just a matter of profit taking? How much more upside do we have for Indian equities?
The rally yesterday is not surprising. The capital markets in India have clearly wanted a political sense of stability and moreover continuity in reforms. And with the incumbent government coming to power, as exit polls show, with a large majority, there's a belief that you will see policy stability and, in fact, maybe more bold reforms that India needs, given the growth that we're seeing. So I think yesterday's rally is exactly what financial markets, would have wanted. I wouldn't make too much of today's cuts because early numbers have come in as far as actual poll results. I think we'll get a clearer picture closer to noon. I do believe if the number for the NDA government is closer to 400, markets will be happy. If it's not, you might see some cuts. But if the exit polls, do translate into reality, and we'll get that sense by noon, I think this picture could change a little bit.
But Radhika, you got to wonder how important that margin is. After all, Modi is set to still be in power. Policy continuity is set to take place. I mean, isn't there already confidence that we'll see more of the same?
Yes, I think there is. I mean, and to some extent, I think I would go as far as to say over the last few months, Indian markets have rallied and factored in perhaps policy continuity. The only thing is that, if you have a large mandate coming in, then some of the reforms that this government has talked about, particularly bold reforms around land, labor, which are expected because Mr. Modi has talked about India becoming a major manufacturing hub, you have the ability to take on some of the bolder reforms that have been talked about in the last couple of months and year. So I think that's what the market could look forward to.
How would you position your portfolio?
So I think India will see a broad-based market rally. I don't buy the thesis that a portfolio should be positioned for particular sectors. Now, within this, however, historically, I think India's leadership has been driven by services. I do believe that I would position a portfolio with a tilt towards manufacturing. So that means things like industrials, that means sectors like capital goods, anything that's a beneficiary of private sector capital expenditure coming into the markets. I do believe selective themes where the government has intended to focus, defense, for instance, and there's been a large indigenization of defense that India has been working on, already doing about $3 billion in defense exports. So some of those segments, electric vehicles, because the government has talked about, moving the grid to electric. So some of those themes will be satellite parts of the portfolio, but definitely a focus on the investment and manufacturing side of the economy. And as we build India portfolios, a more domestically biased portfolio rather than sectors that are very globally linked.
What's the biggest risk for Indian investors right now, Radhika? And what assumptions are you making about when the RBI might come into play, when that rate cut might come?
So I think, it's tricky to make assumptions, but I think the rate cut, I think you're going to see a period of stable rates. Inflation in India is not out of whack, so that is the good news. But I think the RBI is going to be more cautious than one expects. I think the biggest risk is pieces of overvaluation in some segments. I think on a broad basis, the Indian market is not cheap. Growth is certainly meaningful, and I think continuity in policy and continuity in government will attract global investors who have largely stayed on the sidelines while looking at India with a lot of interest. So I think you're going to see more global capital come in. post an election outcome, a favorable election outcome. I do think parts of the market, small and mid caps, one has to be thoughtful about the kind of valuations that one is paying. So I think one has to be selective in their stock picking there.
We know how India has benefited from investors looking for an alternative to China. A lot of foreign money has been gravitating towards the market here. But now with China showing some signs of recovery, might that money flow revert back to Beijing?
I think, and I attend a number of conferences. I mean, I was at Milken a month ago, and India versus China was a question mark. I don't think India is China plus one. I think India is a narrative of its own, and it's a growth model that is perhaps more similar to the US of the 80s than what China is. So I think global investors are now starting to see that there are differences between the India and China model. As I see China, it's the world's second largest economy. Valuations are certainly more favorable than India, but uncertainty factors are significantly higher than India. I think with India, you've got a steady base of continuity and growth momentum. So I see one as a turnaround and one as a sustained winner. Of course, valuations are very different. So I think investors honestly, have very, very different viewpoints on how to look at India and China, but I don't think India is China plus one.
Radhika, thank you so much for your insights today. Radhika Gupta, CEO and MD of Edelweiss Mutual Fund. Let's do a check on how Indian markets are doing.